all because of Bethlehem. From a child in a cradle to a king upon a cross, he knew the road was leading him to pay a crimson cost. And when no other arms could carry the weight of all our sin, he took the fall, and it happened all because of Bethlehem.
Good evening, and welcome to Brighterside Church on this wonderful Wednesday, December 6th. I'm Pastor Austin. It's nice to have you here tonight. We are going to continue our way through Romans tonight. We are currently at, I believe it's week 4, how we receive God's forgiveness. But to be sure, give me a minute to check in on our channel and make sure that I'm correct. Give me 1 second. Yes, we are working on Romans 4 this week, for week 4, and it is how we receive God's forgiveness. And that's what we're going to be studying tonight in the Bible. So I just want to go ahead and say, if you have brought your Bible, you may read out of there. We're going to be reading out of the New International Version, the NIV tonight, for our Bible study. If you're reading from a King James, it'll be a lot different just because it's more broader, not really broader, but more bold and more words that are more enlightened. They're very, what's the word here? Advanced. So that's why I'm using the NIV. It's easier to understand. I haven't used these for quite some time, but I do want to grab a random card out of the Hagee Ministries little kit here. I got this in one of Pastor Hagee's, Hagee Ministries, out of one of their kits that I gave a donation for, extra donation, and got this. So I'm just going to pick a random card out of here, and that's what we're going to do tonight. So this one's called Gratitude. Let me go ahead and set the rest of these back in there. This one's Gratitude. I'm going to read you guys this side. Isaiah 61, verse 10. I will rejoice greatly in the Lord. My soul will exalt in my God, for he has clothed me with garments of salvation. He has covered me with a robe of righteousness, as a bridegroom puts on a turban, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels. Isaiah 61, verse 10. That's our random scripture card for tonight. Let's go ahead and get into our ways on how to give your gift, your tithe, or your offering to Brighterside Church. And once we do that, really you're giving it to God. But that will really help fulfill God's promise and help us bring our ministry all across the globe. We'd be grateful for your offering. I'm going to go ahead and give you some information on how to give. Now, on the back screen is Bible Gateway. We'll talk about that here in a minute. I'll give you guys the sign-in information and all of that. If you want to log in with Bible Gateway tonight, I encourage you to read from a regular Bible if you have your own. But you can log in, whichever one you prefer. Let's go ahead and talk about how to give. So, over on our YouTube channel, Brighterside Church, if you guys are watching there, you may also be watching on our podcast. If you're watching over on our podcast, I'm going to open up Apple Podcasts real quick. On all of our stuff here on our channel, under our About right here, you can find a section here. You'll find these credits. They're just giving some credit to one of the persons who make you'll see on each different music video, different people make them. I did not make them. So I'm giving credits here to Landon Gingerich for making our cinematography and our lyric videos for some of our songs. We've kind of, like, used them a lot, so I kind of went on to some other channels, but their stuff is linked there. But I just want to give him some really good credits because his stuff is just so good. But you'll find here information, and you can give in three different ways. You can give by going to our website, which is https://austinluxurylife12.wixsite.com/brightersidechurch. If you go to the website over here, you can click right over there, and it will bring you to our webpage. You can give your tithe and offering in three different ways. You can give it through Venmo, PayPal, and Cash App. If you're new here, I recommend using Cash App. It's probably the more easier way to give your tithe, your offering, or gift. And you just click on that, and then you just scan my code. If you need help with this, please email me at PastorAustinBSC@gmail.com. Again, that's PastorAustinBSC@gmail.com. Or call that phone hotline, 814-429-3790. Again, that's 814-429-3790. And along with that, you can give through email or, again, by calling that phone hotline, 814-429-3790. If you do want to give through email, I'll show you exactly how you can kind of give that. You'll go into your email, you'll click compose, you'll type in PastorAustinBSC@gmail.com. Make sure it picks me up there. And then just type in tithe and then just say, hi, I would like to give a tithe of $65. $65. Whatever you want to give, or if it's a tithe and offering, a tithe would be your 10%, or a partial, whatever, and then offering, anything further you want to give, basically is what that is. And then you would just put in there your debit card number, or your account and routing number, anything such as that, and then you'd be good to go. If you do use account and routing number, I do have to have a check. You would have to write me a checkout. So, easiest way is a debit card. And then just type in there your debit card number. 1234-5678. Whatever your debit card number is, and your expiration, 0928, and your back number, which could be, I don't know, 111 or 000. Whatever it may be. And then send that over, and then just say, thank you. And then make sure you just sign your name. For example, I don't know. Jesus. There's a good example. Just sign your name over there, anybody, and we'll get you going. So, with that being said, that's how you want to give your tithe and your offering. On our website as well, if you go under our forms right here, you can log in right there, make a page, and then you can view our prayer request. Now, last week I started prayer request 3 days ago, which was back on Sunday. Was it Sunday? Saturday, I think I did. It was asking for prayers for schools, for safety. So just add more prayers there, check it out, and that's that. So that being said, let's go ahead and jump into our Bible study tonight. Now, if you guys have been with us for a little while, by the way, if you want to follow us on Twitter, you can, or X, whatever you want to call it. I have my personal Twitter here. If you want to follow my personal Twitter, you can. It's Auslyn7, A-U-S-L-Y-N-N-7. I post about my regular videos and all of that. But our church page is brighter_church, and you can follow us over there. And I talk about different Sundays and different services and what you can look out for and just some motivation throughout your week. Let's go ahead though and get back to Bible Gateway. This is Bible Gateway. Now to log in, you can make your own account or you can sign into our shared Brighterside Church account. Now this email is going to be passed for the email. You just want to type in is PastorAustinBSC@gmail.com. For us all here at Brighterside Church, our congregation. And for the password, just type in capital B for Brighterside Church. R-I-H-G-H-T-S-I-D-E 1. Brighterside. Oops. Sorry, you want to type in capital B, Brighterside Church 1. And then just click on log in. And it will log you in under Brighterside Church, and then you can view all of our highlights, different things that I've checked out. They have an app, I believe, And tonight, we're going to be, like I said, working in the NIV, New International Version, under Romans 4. We got not too much to work on. Now, just jumping forward to our next weeks here, I just want to show you guys what is done and what is not done. I'm going to make these all little, like, check things, because that way I can actually check them off. We're going to mark this week done, week 3, and all them done. We got week 5 is coming up next week. We're going to take a look at how deep our need for forgiveness goes. Then Romans 6 and 7 on week 6. Romans 8 on week 7, Romans 9 through 11 on week 8, Romans 12 on week 9, Romans 13 on week 10, 14 on week 11, and 15 through 16, and that will finalize Romans by week 12. Now, we're looking at this week here, which is December 5th. I'm filming this a day ahead of schedule. But if we're taking a look here in our calendar, looking at December, as you guys can see here, it's going to lead us into January. Now, this is this Wednesday here, the 6th. This is going to be for week 4. And then we're going to have week 5, week 6. Yeah, week 4, 5, 6, 7. Then we'll go into the new year, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We will finish this entire Bible study just after the first month of the new year, starting on February 7th. How does that work? Oh, never mind, that's right. Yeah, February 7th will begin that brand new time for our different Bible study. And I think we're going to work on something next. I got to look up a new little plan, but we got a while before that happens. So that's that, you guys. But let's go ahead and begin Romans 4. Now, again, I'll highlight different things that need to stand out. We'll take a look at what all this is supposed to mean. But in general, as you guys could kind of see in my notes, basically this just talks about how deep our need for forgiveness goes. Or I'm sorry, no, how we receive God's forgiveness. That is this week, Romans 4, how we receive God's forgiveness. So why exactly do we need his forgiveness is next week. This week is how we receive God's forgiveness. Let's go ahead and begin reading. I'm going to go ahead and zoom this in some, that way we can see. And let's go ahead and begin reading. I apologize for the ads across the screen. Let's go ahead and begin reading. Romans 4. Abraham justified by faith. What then shall we say that Abraham, our forefather according to the flesh, discovered in this matter? If in fact Abraham was justified by works, he had something to boast about, but not before God. What does Scripture say? Abraham believed God, and it was credited to him as righteousness. Now to the one who works, wages are not credited as a gift, but as an obligation. However, to the one who does not work, but trusts God, who justifies the ungodly, their faith is credited as righteousness. David says the same thing when he speaks of the blessedness of the one to whom God credits righteousness apart from works. Blessed are those whose transgressions are forgiven, whose sins are covered. Blessed is the one whose sin in the Lord will never count against them. Is this blessedness only for the circumcised or also for the uncircumcised? I'm going to highlight that. We've been talking about this. If you missed our previous Bible studies, looking at Scripture, you do not have to be circumcised to be forgiven. It's about being circumcised in. Being circumcised with a heart. Okay? We have been saying that Abraham's faith was credited to him as righteousness. Under what circumstances was it credited? Was it after he was circumcised or before? It was not after, but before he was circumcised. I'm giving some extra thing here. It was not after, but before. Meaning before he was circumcised. And he received circumcision as a sign, a seal of the righteousness that he had by faith while he was still uncircumcised. So then he is the father of all who believe, have not been circumcised, in order that righteousness might be credited to them. And he is then also the father of the circumcised, who not only are circumcised, but who also follow in the footsteps of the faith that our father Abraham had before he was circumcised. Let's take a look back at 12. I'm going to highlight the most important things in blue that I really want to stand out. Looking at verse 12 of Romans 4, let's read this again. And he is then also the father of the circumcised, who not only are circumcised, but who also follow in the footsteps of the faith that our father Abraham had before he was circumcised. So looking back at this textual evidence here in Romans 12, let's make a note. I want to create a note for this for you all to look back on as long as you sign into our Bible Gateway account. I'm going to go ahead. Who not only are circumcised, but who also follow in the footsteps of the faith that our father Abraham had before he was circumcised. Let's go ahead and quote that. And I just want to talk about textual evidence. Looking back at this right here, what is this pointing out to us this evening? Who not only are circumcised, but also follow in the footsteps of the faith. So this is meaning you cannot be given faith You can't have faith just by being circumcised. There are millions of people who decide later in the road they want to get circumcised, or their parents circumcise them as an infant when they're a baby. Just by being circumcised does not mean that you have faith automatically. It does not mean that we then fall in the footsteps of the faith that our father Abraham had before he was circumcised. You can't have that faith just by being circumcised. So don't think because you're circumcised, you have the same faith and who follow in the footsteps of the faith that our father Abraham had before he was circumcised. That's not true. This is right here. This verse 12 of Romans 4 is saying that you must have faith and whether you're circumcised or not. You can be circumcised physically or circumcised by the heart. A good question people ask, well, how can a woman be circumcised? Is this mentioning women? Yes. It's mentioning women being circumcised, even though they cannot physically be circumcised, they are circumcised by the heart. Men can take a sacrifice basically by getting it done physically. You can't have faith just by being circumcised. You may get circumcised either physically or by the heart. But you still must have true believing faith. In the footsteps of Abraham that he had before he was circumcised. I wanted to prove that big point. I want to leave a little note there and highlight that. That's something that's pretty important. Okay. Let's go ahead and continue reading. It was not through the law that Abraham and his offspring received the promise that he would be heir of the world, but through the righteousness that comes by faith. For if those who depend on the law are heirs, faith means nothing and the promise is worthless because the law brings wrath. And there is no law, and where there is no law, there is no transgression. Let's go ahead and leave some notes on some more sections throughout 13. It was not through the law that Abraham and his offspring received the promise that he would be heir of the world, but through the righteousness that comes by faith. I'm going to stand that out in blue, and I'm going to leave a note. Not by the law. but by true believing faith. We must have faith for things to happen. Otherwise, we are not believing in God. For if those who depend on the law are heirs, faith means nothing and the promise is worthless because the law brings wrath. I'm going to highlight that in blue. And there is no law. And where there is no law, there is no transgression. Okay? Therefore, the promise comes by faith, so that it may be by grace and may be guaranteed to all Abraham's offspring, not only to those who are of the law, but also to those who have the faith of Abraham. He is the father of us all. As it is written, I have made you a father of many nations. I'm sorry, I meant to make that pink. I might make it pink again. It's not one to change colors. Let's try it again. There we go. He is our Father in the sight of God, in whom he believed. The God who gives life to the dead and calls into being things that were not. Against all hope, Abraham in hope believed, and so became the father of many nations, just as it had been said to him, so shall your offspring be. Without weakening in his faith, he faced the fact that his body was as good as dead, since he was about 100 years old. And that Sarah's womb was also dead. Yet he did not waver through unbelief regarding the promise of God, but was strengthened in his faith and gave glory to God, being fully persuaded that God had power to do what he had promised. Either way, this is pointing out, this is what we have to be following. We must believe and have faith that something will happen by the power of God. Otherwise, it may not happen. We must trust God in all circumstances. That's our note for that. We must trust God in all circumstances. Give me 1 minute. My dog is snoring really loudly. Give me a second.
Hey, buddy.
You okay? Wake up, Bubba. Anyway. He gets really, stuffed up whenever he sleeps, and he has to wake up and, clear out his nose. He's good now. Let's continue. This is why it was credited to him as righteousness. The words, it was credited to him, were written not for him alone, but also for us. I'm going to add my own footnote. Every single thing in the Bible is for us to learn, to understand, and to follow. This is the book of God with God's laws and true reasoning. This is the book of life. Follow it, obey it, and read it. To whom God will credit righteousness for us who believe in him, who raised Jesus from our Lord from the dead. He was delivered over to death for our sins and was raised to life for our justification. Summarizing Romans 4, This is talking again about that note, how we receive God's forgiveness. We receive God's forgiveness by following the laws of God, truly getting that forgiveness from Him, asking for it, and then following the laws of the book. But not only following the laws, it's not just about following the laws and obeying to God and knowing Him as our Father and having our Lord Jesus Christ as our Lord and our Savior. That's not the only part about it. There's one more part that a lot of people seem to forget when we look at Romans 4. Now I'm going to ask a question. I actually want you all to think about it. What do you think that part is after reading back in Romans 4? There's something that you and God and the Lord of the Lord Jesus and the Holy Spirit, there's something that we all share with them, with God, with Jesus, with the Holy Spirit. There's something that we share. Think about your wife, your mother, your father, your best friend, your dog. What do you call your friendship, your mother, your love for your wife, your love for your mom or your dad, your love for your brother or sister, your love for your aunt and uncle, your love for your nieces and nephews? A relationship. People often forget they need a relationship with God. People often run to Him. Oh God, please forgive me. Give me mercy and Jesus come back into my heart. That's amazing. It truly is. And then people, okay, all I gotta do is just follow the law. Follow the law and I'm good. Which, lawfully speaking, you probably are. You probably end up in heaven. But God's not satisfied with just that. God is not just satisfied with you following the law. God's not just satisfied with you going to Him in prayer and just, please forgive me. I messed up. I sinned. What needs to happen is a true relationship between you and Christ. If there's no relationship, where do you get connected with God? Now you're talking to God like your boss at work. Oh, I'm so sorry, I messed up. I will do better. I'll see you tomorrow, boss. God may be your boss, but He's a lot more than your boss. You have a Lord and a Savior who loved you so much that He died for you. And people often just think, all I have to do is ask forgiveness and follow the law. No. Read your Bible. Pick it up. Still, follow the law, yes. But what does God want the most? We learned from the little boy. I watched the movie. Was it Ezekiel? I can't, but I don't remember the name. I'm sure a lot of you are like, I know them right now. Daniel. No. I can't believe I didn't know that. There is a movie. How did I not know that? How do I forget about that? I think it's God, or I think it's the devil trying to stop me from our Bible study tonight. The angel that was sent back, it was a young boy, and he was in a movie which was based off the real. He made him a young boy again instead of an old man and sent him back to Earth. And I actually watched a movie that was based on it in the Bible. And it was one of God's messengers, who was then an angel who came back to Earth to help save the Earth and bring God back to a small town. And it hadn't rained there in, years. And it was a movie based on it. Gabriel! There we go! I'm sure that you're just screaming in your thing. It's Gabriel! Yes, it's Gabriel! Gabriel! He came back and he told us that we are supposed to focus, and that God really what God wants is for us to take time and pray to God, talk to God, have a relationship, build a connection with God. Not just go to him, I am your servant, Lord. I will follow your laws. Amen. No! He wants more than that. He wants a relationship with you. Some of you have a father or a mother who you don't have a relationship with. But there's some of you out there who don't, but really want one. That's what God's feeling. He wants to connect with you. He wants to get in touch with you. Learn to pick up the phone. Quit declining God's call. Quit declining God's call. That's what we're looking at here. Through Abraham and through faith. And how that's not the only thing that matters. This isn't the only thing that matters. The law is not the only thing that matters. What we truly have to try to do is maintain a relationship, maintain a connection, maintain our talk, and talk to God. And some people say, I don't know what to say to God. Okay, you call your mom, what do you talk about? Tell God the same thing. I'm one of those people who I think about God all the time. I pray about things, and I even just, thank you, Lord, for this day. But even rarely do I ever, I just thank him for the day. The best thing is to make a habit, okay? It can be anything. It can be a simple prayer of, thank you, Lord, for a brand new day. It can be reciting Bible verses, thanking God for this night, thanking God for the meal that you have on the table, thanking God for your cup of water, thanking God for anything, anything at all. And don't just thank him for the good things, thank him for the bad. Thank him all the time. In all times, give thanks. So that's what we're looking at here. Our main things is to keep a relationship with God and understand it and follow it. Follow the law, but to also maintain a relationship. And that is truly how we will end up receiving God's forgiveness. And truly believing in the faith. Because their faith is credited as righteousness. Remember that. Okay, everybody. Well, that's going to sum up tonight's Bible study. I thank you all for stopping by on this wonderful Wednesday night. Thank you so much. If you want to get that tithe and that offering, more information down below in the description box or at the beginning of today's episode. Thank you for tuning in. Have a wonderful rest of your week, and I will see you in Sunday for our church service. Have a great rest of your week. Thank you for attending BSC. Our Twitter page, our email, and our website are linked, and we'll see you in our next worship session. Have a great day.